Good morning, students. What are seen in the previous class, ma? That is components of vector. What is scalar product? What is vector product? What are the properties of scalar product? What are the properties of vector product? That all are discussed in the previous class. Okay. In the today's session, we will discuss about that distance, displacement, and momentum. Okay. Distance, displacement, and momentum. So let us enter this topic. First, you should know about properties of component of vector. What is mean by component of vector, ma? Component, just as will be mentioned, you have to take one vector, you just mention that the vector in x axis, that vector in y axis, that vector in z axis. That is ax, a vector in x axis, vector in y axis, vector in z axis. That are all other components of vector. So components of vector is nothing but vectors will be denoted with the Cartesian coordinate system. That is called vector in components of vector, sorry, vector in x, y axis will be tells the components of vector. Okay, so now we will going for we will go to properties of components of vector. What's the meaning that properties of components of vector? Properties of components of vectors tell that, for example, you have to take two vectors, a vector and b vector. Okay, you have to consider that the two vectors will be same. Okay, so first vector you should mention at the three Cartesian coordinate system, ax I plus AYJ plus AZK, okay, is equal to B, BXI, BYJ, BYJ plus BZK, okay. So AXI, AYJ, AZK, BXI, BYJ, BZK. So two vectors will be mentioned with the Cartesian coordinate system along with the unit vectors. X axis I vector, I cap, and Y axis J cap, Z axis K cap, again as well as the B vector also, okay. And the X component, that is unit vector, Y component, that is unit vector, Z component, that is unit vector, that is add the components of vector. Suppose we have to consider the two vectors will be same. A vector will be equal to B vector, the components of the vector are also same. What's the meaning that component of A vector AX, it will be equal to components of B vector BX. Components of A in Y axis, that is component of A and A, Y component of A and then Y component of B. Then Z component of A and Z component of B. So what's the meaning that now? Two vectors will be same, the components of vector will be same. Okay, clear that? The two vectors will be same, the components vector will be same. Okay, this is the properties of components of vector. Have to take the two vectors. The vectors will be, you have to write in the x component and y component and z component. It will be multiplied with the unit vectors also. So axi, ayj, azk is equal to bxi, byj, bzk. And then two vectors will be equal, automatically the components have to be equal. So the two vectors will be equal, na ax is equal to bx, ay is equal to by, az is equal to bz. This is the properties of component of vector. Next we will go for vector addition. What is the meaning of vector addition? Already I discussed how to add the two vectors, how to subtract the two vectors, how to product two vectors, how to multiply by scalar product and vector product. Now multiplication is done by scalar product and vector product, that all also discussed in the previous classes. But in the today's session, how to add the two vectors? You have to take ax. You have to take a vector is equal to ax and ay plus az, and b vector is equal to bxi, byj plus bzk. We have to add the two vectors. So a vector plus b vector is equal to ax, okay, ax plus bx into I cap, okay, then ay plus by into j cap, because the both the component x and x component and I unit vector as I. So you have to easily add ax plus bx into I, ay plus by into j plus az plus bzk, okay. So this is the, this all are the addition of two vectors. How to add two vectors? So addition of two vectors means ax plus bx into I, ay plus by into j, az plus bz into k. How to subtract the two vectors? A vector minus b vector. So a vector minus b vector is equal to, you have just to simplify, plus it will be changed into minus ax minus bx into I cap, plus ay minus by into j cap plus az minus bz into k cap. This is all over the components of vector. How to add the two vectors with components, how to subtract the two vectors with components. Okay, just to add, you have to add the x component of 2 and then y component of 2 and z component of 2. Suppose you have to subtract, just subtract x component and y component and then z component. This is the way you have to add the two vectors. Okay, then we will go for the position vector. What's the meaning that position vector? Suppose you have to consider one vector, the vector will be in the angle of x, y, z axis. One vector will be lying in three Cartesian coordinate axes. For example, this is the one vector we have to consider, one vector that is x, y, z. B is a vector, but the vector will be lying in a x, y, z axis. Three axes it will be along, okay? Three axis lane and the vectors will be x, y, z axis lane. So just as mentioned, the position vector is equal to, position vector r vector is equal to x I vector plus y j vector plus z k vector. What's the meaning that ma? J cap, okay? X axis position vector, y axis position vector, z axis position vector. So one vector or one thing, it will be moving three Cartesian coordinate system, x, y, z axis. Just to mention as xi, yj plus zk, okay? So this is the position vector. Position vector is nothing but the location. Position vector tells the location of one thing, location of one vector. One vector in that locate area bin this the denote pandrathu perna position vector. So position vector always denoted as r vector. R vector is equal to xi plus yj plus zk, okay? This is the position vector. Then in your book having one problem, okay, that the problem is having 2.13 problem. It will be give one graph, x, y axis base, one graph, that the graph will be tells the movement of P, Q or S. Four vectors is there, P, Q or S. The four vectors will be mentioned in the x, y, z axis, sorry. X and minus x axis, y and minus y axis. X, y axis la four particle movement would be graph of the kanga, okay ma? You have to tell the position vectors, okay? So first, you start from P, okay? Start from P. P, where it will be located? Where it is located? The P, the location of P is, by using the mathematical graph denotation, P is, P it will be lying in the x axis 3, V it will be lying in x axis 3 and then lying in x axis 3 and then y axis it will be 4, okay? 2, 3 and then 4. 3 layer, 4 layer, okay? So 3 comma 3 in x axis and 0 in y axis. So just as mentioned as x axis in I cap and y axis in j cap, okay? So in x axis 3, okay? So the position of P vector is equal to 3 into, that's the unit vector, x axis unit vector I cap plus 0 j cap. I hope that you should understood, sorry, easily understood this part. The position vector P will be equal to x axis plus y axis. X axis is 3. So 3 I vector plus 0. Sorry, 0, not a 0, that is 4. 4 j cap. P vector just is there. So P vector is 3 comma 3, okay? 3 in x axis, y axis it will be 0. So 0 j cap. But Q, x axis 4, y axis 4. X axis 4 and y axis 4. Suppose you have to take x axis 3 and y axis 3. So x axis is 5 here to now. X axis is 5. X axis is 5. So just mention as 5 I vector plus 4 j vector. How did you mention ma? The x axis is 5. So unit vector is I vector 5 I cap plus y axis is 4. So the unit vector j cap. So 4 j. Then r you have to mention. P, already I tell that the position vector P and position vector Q. And now the position vector R. R when it is located ma? What is the location of R? In x axis 2, but in a negative x direction, so minus 2. But y axis is 0, so this is the minus x direction. So you have to mention as minus 2 and unit vector I care plus y axis, not to be in any lines is there, so 0. So 0 j cap. Okay, clear that? Then s vector it form. Okay, p 3i plus 0j and q 5i plus 4j and r minus 2 because minus x direction, so opposite x direction, so minus 2 plus 0j. Okay, then now s. Where is s now? This is the s. This is the y axis, but opposite y axis, so minus y. When x axis is 3, so 3. In x axis is 3, so 3 I cap, but y axis in opposite y axis, so minus 6 is there, so minus 3 j cap. These are the position vectors that will be mentioned as P, Q, O, S. So the graph will be denote the P, Q, O, S position vector. Just I mentioned that what is P, what is Q, what is R, what is S. So the position vector at the point of P, position vector at the point of Q, position vector at the point of R, position vector at the point S. The position vector is nothing but the vector, it will be in a x axis and a y axis position, that's all. Okay. So in the graph learn then you know x axis la enga place aayirukku, y axis la enga place aayirukku, adu positive x axis ah negative x axis ah, positive y axis ah negative y axis ah, adha pottu enna cheyanum inge position vector ah write panum. So position vector just tells the location of one vector, it just tells the one location of one object. Okay, first I will tell that what is the properties of components of vector, second how to add the two vectors, and then now I explain that position vectors. Okay, position vectors just tell the denote the location of one vector, location of one object. Okay, now I explain that multiplication of vector by a scalar. How to multiply vector by a scalar? How to multiply vector by a scalar? Ma, just I tell that one vector, that is a vector. Okay, that is I consider as one vector, that is a vector. This is the vector. You have to multiply with one scalar. The scalar it will be denoted as lambda. Okay. Definitely multiplying a one vector and scalar will definitely give the vector. So vector means but the scalar is positive value. Positive value. The vector is positive. A vector plus positive a vector. Suppose a vector will be multiplying with a negative scalar. Just the a vector is minus a vector. What's the meaning that, ma'am? Multiplication of vector by a scalar, it will definitely give the vector, but the direction is only depend upon the scalar. Scalar positive or negative, other put our direction. So you should mention with one vector, it will be multiplied with one scalar. Scalar is positive, the vector is also positive. One vector will be multiplied with the negative of scalar. Scalar is negative, so vector also negative. Okay. This is the multiplication vector by a scalar. So definitely the one vector will be multiplied with one scalar, it definitely gives the vector. I will give some examples. Okay. So first you should decide one A vector. That is a line, one line. Okay. That is the A vector. We want four A vector. How to denote ma? In geometrically and analytically, this is a vector. We want four a vector. So one vector and two vector and three vector and four vector. That is four a vector. So four types of a vector. So a vector, this is a vector, this is a vector, and this is a vector, and this is a vector. We want four a vector. So four into a vector. So four times the line is there. This is the four a vector. Suppose we want minus four a vector. Just multiply in opposite direction. This is a minus 4a vector because this vectors will be moving in a forward direction. These vectors will be moving in opposite direction. This is minus 4a vector. So just a one vector to be denoted. We want to multiply in a number. It just is mentioned the number of that lines. Okay. Okay. Then I explain that another one. What's the force formula? Force F is equal to m in the A. Okay, force it will be product of mass and acceleration. Okay, force it will be equal to mass and acceleration. Force M is mass. Mass scalar or vector ma? Scalar. because mass does not denote the direction, just only mention the value. So mass is a scalar and acceleration is vector, because acceleration is increases and decreases with the time along the direction. So acceleration is the vector. So multiplying scalar and vector, definitely it will give the vector, that is force. Okay, so mass is a scalar quantity, acceleration is a vector quantity. The multiplying scalar and vector, definitely it will give the vector. And another one example I will give, F is equal to Q into E. Okay, Q into E means force, electrostatic force. It will be equal to product of one of the charge and electric field. So electric field is a vector, charge is a scalar. See, multiplying scalar and vector, it will definitely give the vector. Clear that, ma'am? Vector just mentioned with the top arrowhead. So top arrowhead will be only E portion and A portion. Okay. So this is a force. This is the normal force. This is the electrostatic force. Electrostatic force will be equal to the product of one of the charge and electric field. Then another one example. P is equal to M into V. Momentum, it will be equal to mass into velocity. Mass is a scalar quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. But velocity vector quantity is just mentioned as vector form. So multiplication of vector by a scalar, it will be definitely give a vector. So momentum is equal to mass into velocity. So that all are the multiplication of vector by a scalar. So one vector, it will be definitely multiplied with the scalar, definitely it will give a vector. But the positive and negative, it will be depend upon the scalar. Okay, clear that, ma? So idella already examples. Okay, now we will go for distance and displacement. This is our topic, distance and displacement. What is the meaning that distance and displacement? How will you mention that distance and displacement? What is distance, ma? You have to the distance, you have to measure the distance between your home to your school. Okay, so just to measure the distance between your home to your house, sorry, your home to your school. So nearly 10 kilometer or 2 kilometer. 2 kilometer is just to mention the distance. Okay, so just the distance. We start from your home, you have to reach one first landmark and second landmark and third landmark, and then you have to reach the school. Okay, that is B. So these your home and it is your school. Okay, so you have to first reach the first landmark and second landmark and third landmark and fourth landmark. And last, you have to reach your school. This is the path length is traveled by a particle. Path length is traveled by a particle in the various portions. So first portion reach some distance, second portion reach some distance, and third portion reach some distance, and fourth portion reach some distance. So have to all the distance, you have to add it and to get the distance. This is distance. Distance is nothing but actual path length is traveled by a particle. Okay. But displacement is nothing but just to denote the length of two portions. AB, ippadi sutti valachu pogama, just to be mentioned as A to B. Suppose you have to consider me to you, just as a moreover, 50 meters is there. But I have to, first I stand is there, okay? I stand is there. Just I move to the next side. In a simple question, that is A to B is a displacement. But I have to move in first this point and then this point. I have to cover on the various levels. That is called distance. Distance is not only sutti sutti vandu or a place reach pandra vera distance. But displacement na correct accurate on the point and the final point end ke adeyla ulla distance. So that is called displacement. Okay, so distance and displacement will be mentioned with the Cartesian coordinate system also. So displacement vector, how to displacement vector will be mentioned in the Cartesian coordinate system. So Cartesian coordinate system, I will give one example for that Cartesian coordinate system. 2.17 example. So in our book having one problem this day. So in x-axis and y-axis, 2.17 problem, example problem. One graph is there. Some value will be mentioned in x-axis, some value will be mentioned as y-axis. This is the displacement vector. Displacement vector means one thing it will be moving B to Q. Okay, பிங்க பாயிண்ட் வந்து கியூங்க பாயிண்ட்டுக்கு ஒரு திங்க் வந்து மூவ் ஆகுது, அதாவது ஒரு வெக்டார் மூவ் ஆகுது. இதோடைய டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் வெக்டார் என்ன நம்ம ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணணும். ஓகேவா? டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் வெக்டார்னா என்ன, இங்கே ஆர் ஒன் இஸ் அ பொசிஷன் வெக்டார், 0 to P இஸ் அ ஆர் ஒன் வெக்டார், 0 to Q இஸ் அ ஆர் டூ வெக்டார், திஸ் இஸ் த பொசிஷன் வெக்டார் ஆர் ஒன், திஸ் இஸ் த பொசிஷன் வெக்டார் ஆர் டூ. ஓகே, ஸோ வி வாண்ட் டு நோ தட் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் த சாரி டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் பிட்வீன் த டூ பொசிஷன் வெக்டார்ஸ். So displacement, how to mention the displacement vector in the Cartesian coordinate system? இங்கே கார்டிஷியன் கோஆர்டினேட் சிஸ்டம் என்னது, எக்ஸ் அண்ட் ஒய், எக்ஸ் ஒய் ஆக்சஸில் ஒரு வெக்டாரை நீங்கள் டினோட் பண்ணிக்கிங்க, அதுக்கு எப்படி டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் வெக்டார் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும், இதுதான் கான்செப்ட். ஓகேவா? ஹவு டு கேல்குலேட் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் வெக்டார் டெல்ஆர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஆர் டூ மைனஸ் ஆர் ஒன், பிகாஸ் ஆர் டூ இஸ் அ பொசிஷன் வெக்டார் ஆஃப் கியூ அண்ட் ஆர் ஒன் இஸ் அ பொசிஷன் வெக்டார் ஆஃப் ஆர் ஒன். ஒரு திங்கோடைய நீங்கள் டிஸ்டன்ஸையோ டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட்டோ கேல்குலேட் பண்ணால் என்ன பண்ணுவோம், ரெண்டு கடையில் உள்ள டிஸ்டன்ஸை மெஷர் பண்ணுவோம். திஸ் இஸ் த சேம் வே இட் பி மென்ஷன் இன் வெக்டார் ஃபார்ம். This is the distance between the R1 and R2. So difference between R2 minus R1, it will be give the displacement vector. Okay? So you want know that R, what is R1, what is R2? What is R1? R1 is there. Okay? R1 is there. At a point B, what is x-axis? What is y-axis? At a point B, x-axis is 1. Then y-axis is 1. Okay? So x-axis, it will be mentioned with their unit vector. Y-axis, it will be mentioned with their unit vector. So 1 i cap. And 1 j cap. Clear that, na? So in x-axis one value is there, so 1 into i cap. In y-axis one value is there, so 1 into j cap. This is the unit vector. Sorry, this is the position vector R1. Then position vector of R2, we have to check that. So 4 in x-axis. So 4 i cap plus 2 in y-axis. So 2 j cap. Clear? So position vector R1, position vector R2, you have to mention with the x-y-axis. We want to tell R. How to calculate, ma? Tell R is equal to R2 minus R1. So 4i cap plus 2j cap minus R1 is i cap plus j cap. Okay? One i cap plus one j cap. Just i cap, you have to subtract 4i cap. So 4i cap minus 1i cap plus 2i cap. Sorry, 2j cap minus 1j cap. So what's the value, ma? 4i minus 1i, 3i. 3i cap plus 2j minus 1j, 1j cap. This is the answer for displacement vector in this graph. ஒரு கிராஃப் கொடுத்தாங்கன்னா அதோடய கொஷன் வெக்டாரை நீங்கள் டினோட் பண்ணி அது வந்து டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் வெக்டாக கேல்குலேட் பண்ணணும். நார்மலி இன்னொரு டே டு லைஃப் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் இட் வி ஜஸ்ட் மென்ஷன் த டிஸ்டன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் த டூ கொஷன். பட் இன் கிராஃபிகலி த கொஷன் வெக்டர்ஸ் யூ ஹேவ் டு ஃபர்ஸ்ட் மென்ஷன் அண்ட் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் வெக்டர் ஆஃப்டர் யூ ஹேவ் டு கேல்குலேட். ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் அ வே யூ ஈஸிலி மென்ஷன் தட் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் வெக்டர் இன் த கார்டீசியன் கோஆர்டினேட் சிஸ்டம். மோஷன் அலாங் ஒன் ஆக்சிஸ்ன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. XY axis-ல ஒரு திங்க் மூவ் ஆகுதுன்னா அதில் எப்படி நம்ம டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் வெக்டர் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். ஓகேவா? நவ் ஐ எக்ஸ்பிளைன் தட் வாட்ஸ் த டிஸ்டன்ஸ், வாட்ஸ் த டிஃபரன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் அண்ட் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட். வாட்ஸ் த டிஃபரன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் அண்ட் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட்? யூ ஹேவ் டு டெல் ஒன் பாயிண்ட், வாட் இஸ் டிஸ்டன்ஸ், வாட் இஸ் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் மா? டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் அ பாத் லென்த் இட் வில் பி டிராவல்டு பை அ பார்ட்டிக்கல். Path length, it will be traveled by a particle. First point, the total path length is traveled by a particle. Total path length is traveled by the particle. What does it mean then? ஒரு திங் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ண பொசிஷன்ல இருந்து ஃபினிஷிங் ரீச் ஆகிற வரைக்கும் என்னென்ன பொசிஷன்லாம் மீட் பண்ணியிருக்கோ அதுதான் பாத் லென்த். ஸோ பாத் லென்த் இஸ் ட்ராவல்டு பை அ பார்ட்டிகல் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பாயிண்ட். இங்கே டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் பிட்வீன் இனிஷியல் அண்ட் ஃபைனல் பொசிஷன், difference between initial and final position of an object. Initial and final position of an object. Initial and final position of an object, what's the meaning that? Initial and final, and the putting on the point, and the particular difference. That is difference between initial and final position of a particle. And what's the second point? Distance always a scalar quantity. But displacement is always a vector quantity. Okay? Because displacement just mentioned with their direction also. Then third one, distance always positive, never be negative or zero. Zero avo allad negative avo irukadu, but displacement can be positive, negative and zero also. So displacement is always having the various values, positive, negative and zero. What's the fourth point? Distance always greater than displacement. Distance is always greater than displacement. What's the meaning that ma? நீங்கள் இங்கேருந்து ஏங்க பாயிண்ட்லேருந்து பி வரைக்கும் இப்படி சுற்றி இப்போ ரீச் போகும்போது நிறைய டிஸ்டன்ஸ் வரும். இட் கம்பேரபிள் த டூ கொஷின்ஸ். டூ கொஷனுக்குள்ள டிஸ்டன்ஸை விட நீங்கள் இங்கே கவர் பண்ணக்கூடிய டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் மேபி கிரேட்டர் தன் த டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட். ஸோ டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் கிரேட்டர் தன் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட், சாரி டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் கிரேட்டர் தன் த டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட். பட் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் சம்டைம்ஸ் ஜீரோ, பட் இட் பி லெஸ் தென் த டிஸ்டன்ஸ். எப்போவுமே என்ன செய்யும், டிஸ்டன்ஸை விட லெஸ்ஸாக தான் இருக்கும். So displacement sometimes zero and then less than distance. Then fifth point, distance having more and more values. Having more values, okay? Distance is having more values. But displacement having only one value. Only one value. What's the meaning there? Distance on the reach aga, over at the ka poga poga poga. Various values are reach one. But displacement, it tells only one value. So this is all are the difference between distance and displacement. Distance, total path length traveled by a particle. Displacement, difference between the initial and final position of an object. And distance is a scalar quantity. Displacement is a vector quantity. Distance always a positive, never be negative and zero. And then, but displacement can be positive and negative, it will be zero. And then distance is always greater than the displacement. But displacement, it will be zero and sometimes it will be less than, sorry, sometimes like, most of the time the displacement, it will be less than the distance. And then distance, it will be giving the more and more values. But displacement is giving only one value, okay? So this is the difference between distance and displacement, okay? So now we will go for momentum. What's the meaning that momentum? Momentum is, already I told that, what is the momentum? Momentum is movement. Movement, one thing it will be moved having some velocity. So one thing it will be moving having some velocity. So that is called momentum. Momentum, it will be denoted as P. Okay? P is equal to M into V, that is called momentum. So momentum, one thing it will be moving, having some mass, having some velocity. That will be called as momentum. So momentum, it will be denoted as xy axis, that is px I cap plus py j cap plus pz k cap. What's the meaning that mass? Momentum, it will be mentioned with the xyz coordinate system with the unit vectors. So vx I cap, py j cap, pz k cap is equal to m into vx I cap plus m into vy j cap plus m into vz k cap. Why I didn't mention that the m in x axis, y axis, z axis? No mass, it will be changed in the xyz axis. X, Y, Z axis, end axis line, M ஓட value change ஆகாது. So M into VXI, VX I cap, M into VY J cap, M into VZ K cap, okay? So just mention as PX is equal to, we have to equalize that PX is equal to M into VX and PY is equal to M into VY and PZ is equal to M into VZ. So momentum in x-axis, it will be equal to the formula of m into vx in x-axis. Py is equal to m into vy, pz is equal to m into vz. That is called momentum. Momentum is nothing but just the movement of one particle having some mass, having some velocity. The formula, it will be just mentioned with the xyz coordinate system with along the unit vectors. So, okay, this is called momentum. So, I have to revise that. What is the properties of components of vector? Component of vector, just mention that one vector will be mentioned with the xyz axis. Okay? Properties means two vectors it will be equal, components of two vectors it will be equal. Then vector addition, you have to add the two vectors in xy axis, ax plus bx, ay plus by, az plus bz. That the way that you have to add. Then position vector just to denote the vector in xyz axis. Just add that r vector, it will denote the position vector. Okay? Then how to multiply vector by a scalar. One vector, it will be multiplied with the scalar, definitely will be given the vector, okay? But the vector direction is only depend upon the scalar value. Then now distance and displacement. distance and displacement, we want to calculate the displacement vector. Okay, displacement vector, sometimes the displacement will be zero. What's the way? You have to move to start from your home to school, then again school to home you have to reach it, the displacement will be zero. Other than here, வீட்டில் இருந்து ஸ்கூலுக்கு வந்துட்டு ஸ்கூலில் இருந்து மறுபடியும் நீங்கள் வீட்டுக்கு போகிறீங்க அப்படின்னா அந்த இடத்துல டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் ஜீரோ, பட் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் 2 kilometer இன் பிட்வீன் த யுவர் ஸ்கூல் டு ஹோம். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் யூ ஸ்டார்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஹோம் டு ஸ்கூல் 2 kilometers அண்ட் ஸ்கூல் டு ஹோம் 2 kilometers. ஸோ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் 4 kilometer, பட் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் இஸ் ஜீரோ பிகாஸ் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ண பாயிண்ட்லேயே நீங்கள் திருப்பியும் போயிருக்கீங்க. ஸோ டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் இட் பி ஜீரோ, நீங்கள் அந்த இடத்துல தான் இருக்கீங்க. யூ ஹேவ் டு டிஸ்பிளேஸ் இன் அனதர் ஒன் பொசிஷன். ஸோ டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் இட் பி ஜீரோ, பட் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இட் பி ஹேவிங் சம் வேல்யூ. Then what are the difference between the distance and displacement? Already I tell that there are the 5 points have to learn thoroughly. And then how to calculate the displacement vector? Displacement vector, you have to mention the first position vector and second position vector. Displacement vector will be equal to difference between the two position vectors. Okay, this is the teller is value it will be, you have to calculate. Then now momentum. Momentum is nothing but momentum p is equal to m into v. We have to mention the momentum is along xy z axis, and then value m into vx, m into vy, m into vz also mentioned that. Then you have to equalize that px is equal to m into vx, py is equal to m into vy, pz is equal to m into vz. That all are we have discussed in this session. So today home assignment is, today home assignment, let us learn and write the short answers. Assignment. Learn and write the short answers. Short answers 1 to 8 in book bag. Okay. Book bag la thodi short answer 1 to 8. Okay. So learn and write the short answers 1 to 8 in your book bag. Thank you.